Hello, it's Jim from JetsonHacks.com. On today's show, we're looking at I2C on the NVIDIA Jetson TX2 development kit. Let's get started. There are several I2C buses on the Jetson. Two of them are exposed on the J21 header. I2C devices usually have a data line and an external clock line. Pin 1 of J21 is denoted by this white arrow on the carrier board. On the Jetson, let's talk about I2C bus 1 first. There are two pins, SDA, which is the data, it's on pin 3, and the clock, which is SCL, is on pin 5. The second I2C bus on the J21 header is bus 0. SDA is on pin 27, and SCL is on pin 28. Today we are using a 7-segment LED backpack from Adafruit. The backpack comes as a little kit, which you must solder together. We'll leave a link in the description below on how to assemble the kit. Before we hook up the 7-segment display here that's run over I2C, we make sure that the Jetson is not connected to power. Pin 1 of J21 is denoted by this white arrow on the circuit board. It goes 1, and then this is 2, 3, 4. So the back row is even, and the first row is odd, though it doesn't like to be called that. No one wants to be called odd. Okay, so pin 2 is 5 volts. Pin 6 is ground. Pin 3 is SDA, which is data. And pin 5 is SCL, which is the clock. Okay, let's plug in the power and boot this baby up. We have a library to drive the LED backpack and an example. Let's clone that repository. Now we'll switch over to that repository's directory. Let's install the prerequisites. We need live I2C-dev. Now let's switch over to the example directory. Let's make the example. Before we run the example, let's look at the I2C bus to see if we can see the device. The LED backpack has an address of 70, so we can see it here. This is on bus 1, which is the default bus for the little example that we have. We need sudo here because we are accessing the I2C bus from user space. Ooh, blinking lights. That's a good sign. We have our little example, countdown timer. The clock, all sorts of excitement. Something that confuses people coming from the Jetson TX1 is that the buses are swapped for the pin. Pins 3 and 5 on the Jetson are bus 0. Another thing on the Jetson TX2 is if we look at bus 0, we can see here that on address hex 40, we have the power monitors. These are built into the Jetson module. If you're trying to add a device at that address, you more than likely will fail. If you want to use I2C Bus 0 on the Jetson TX2, go to the pinouts, Jetson TX2. You can see that we were using SDA1 and SCL1 in 5. It's our bus 1. If we go down a little bit, we'll see that if we connected to pin 27 and 28, we would be using I2C bus 0. In order to change our example, let's take a look at that. The first thing we would do is shut the Jetson down. We would wire SDA 27 and SCL to pin 28. In C++ here, we create the HT16K33, which is the LED backpack. Just add this line here. Here we save it, and we compile it. Say make. Let me shut off the machine and rewire it. Let's take a look at bus 0. And there it is, X70. Switch over to our example directory. Our device bus is 0. Ten, nine, eight. All the numbers going down. And we're back to our clock example. I2C is a pretty simple protocol and easy to access on the Jetson TX2. If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up. Thanks for watching.